Okay, so it's a short video on the new Advanced Lookup feature from Microsoft. This is available on most model-driven apps. A couple of things you need to do to enable this first is your administrator will need to come into your environments, under settings, under behavior, and then down here you can see lookup behavior needs to be turned on. You can then set, obviously, you know, your search characters, minimum search characters it will find, and obviously your delay between character input. Once you've enabled this and your administrator has enabled this, then within your model driven app, you can see where you have a lookup field. So in magnifying glass, looking up a custom another table, you get the advanced lookup feature here. As soon as you click onto it, it will then pop up a record. So for this example, we were looking up to parent account. You can see it's now pulling in the accounts table on the left-hand side, and obviously the table we came from was contacts. A couple of things we can then do in here is we can start searching. So we can start searching in here for a value, and you can see it's returning all results. Just remove that. We've got the ability to filter. So like you would do on any normal view, you can filter here. We can change the view. So if you're only looking for a specific dynamic query, like suppliers, for example, we can change that here. You've got the ability to select only your own records. You've got the ability to select a new record and create a new account or a new contact from over here as well. And obviously then once you've found the one that you want, you can select it, and you can see it will say selected record down here. You can click done and it will add it in for this. If you need to see more details around this record, then you've got the ability to click into it as well. By clicking into it, it enables you to then see all the details around this account, make any adjustments that you might need. Obviously then click save or save and close, and it'll automatically add this record to the selected record here as well. If I then click done, this now gets added into the lookup value that we were originally doing. A couple of other things we can then do as well on a couple of different sort of lookup values. So if I just come over here to my activities, you can see I've got this appointment in the system. If I go into this, obviously a regarding field is slightly different in model driven app. So there's more than one table that we could pull a value from. We're not specifying the parent and child relationship. So if we click on the magnifying glass again, you can see we've got the lookup, advanced lookup feature here again. Same features where we can do a filter, we can search, but this time it will pull in all of your tables from your database. So you can then go and okay, this is regarding cases, it's regarding contacts, it's regarding invoices. You can then specify between these different tables over here what it's regarding. And you've got the same features as I just showed you as well. And then the last thing we can also see then as well is most likely on appointments and, you know, activities, you've got this sort of required and optional fields, it's the party fields. If we click on the advanced, if we click on the magnifying glass again and click on advanced lookup, this time around, obviously, because you can have more than one party added to this value, you can see it enables us to go through and add more than one, and it will tell you up here how many you've selected. So in this scenario, I've selected 5 parties for this appointment. I click done, and you can see this will then get added in like so. And so this lovely cool feature, I think this can be used for a few different reasons. You know, again, if you're looking at sort of parent skill sets, you need to flick between the views. You want to then see more data coming from that as opposed to just a quick view card, then again, really useful. If you're happy with this video, please feel free to give it a like. Make sure you subscribe to Preact to see more of our videos about Dynamics 365 and the Power Platform in the future.